Welcome to another episode of our show, Storytime with Becky. Today we're going to be learning about Samson and Delilah. So the Israelites were being rude to God again. They were ignoring him and wouldn't worship him, and they were worshiping idols, and God got very angry and was very sad. God sent an angel, a bright, luminous angel, to a woman who was working in a field and told her that she is going to give birth to a son who would save the Israelite people. And she was very happy by hearing this. She couldn't wait to be the one for her son to save all of her people. But she couldn't help but wonder why her. As Samson grew, God told his parents to never let him cut his hair, because this is the way God would give his power to Samson, so he would be strong and could fight off any army before him. One day, Samson was even walking in a wilderness and discovered a lion. A lion was roaring towards him and was running towards him and was ready to pounce on him, but Samson took him with his bare hands and killed the lion with his bare hands, not needing anything else. He relied only on his power through God that he could fend off this lion and kill him. Samson loved Delilah, and this was his weakness. Delilah worked for the Philistine army, and the Philistines told her they would give her money if she found out just what made Samson so strong, what made Samson undefeatable to any army. So at first, when Delilah asked him, she's like, "Honey, what makes you so strong? What makes you so undefeatable to any army? I just want to know because it's so amazing. You have such a big blessing." At first, Samson lied to her and said, "Well, yes, I am very strong and I can defeat any army before me, but if you tie me to ropes, I won't be able to defeat it. I won't be strong anymore if you tie me to ropes because it'll be too hard for me to unleash out of them." So Delilah took this and waited until Samson was asleep that night. When Samson was sleeping in his bed, she tied his arms to the bed and tied his feet to the bed, and then waited until he was deep asleep and screamed, "The Philistines are coming! The Philistines are coming!" Samson jumped out of bed and ripped the ropes like they were pieces of thread. And Delilah stood back astonished and said, "Samson, this clearly is not your weakness. Clearly you can rip ropes away from you like they're pieces of thread. This is nothing for you. Why won't you tell me your weakness? I just want to be closer to you, and I want to fully understand your situation. I want to understand God's love for you." So Samson finally gave in, and he told Delilah that when he was born, God told his parents to never cut his hair, because his long hair would be how God gave him his power. So again, Delilah waited until Samson was asleep that night, and she went into his room and cut all of his hair off. All of his long locks were cut off and was lying on the floor before him. And then, this is when Delilah told the Philistines about this weakness. The Philistines charged into Samson's house and grabbed him, and Samson couldn't fight them off. Samson, they were too strong for Samson all of a sudden. Samson never knew what it felt like to be so weak and to not have power. It made Samson very sad and couldn't defeat them. So the Philistines grabbed him and threw him in jail. And this gave Samson time to think. But after a while, the Philistines grabbed Samson out of jail and tied him to two columns before the temple. They tied his two hands onto columns and his two feet so the Philistine army could point and laugh and say, "Ha, ha, ha, you're not strong anymore. We're stronger than you and we can defeat you. We're going to leave you up there to watch your people, the Israelites, suffer while we defeat them." Samson was very, very sad. He couldn't believe what he let Delilah do to him. So he prayed to God as he was standing as he was tied to the columns, and he says, "God, please give me one last chance. Please give me power one more time to show these people that you have given me power and that you can defeat any army. God heard his prayer and allowed Samson to grow his hair one last time to defeat the Philistine army. As soon as Samson began to grow his hair, he got stronger and stronger and was able to rip the columns down. He tore the columns down from the roof and the temple came tumbling down. And the temple was just dust. And the Philistine people were killed and were frightened. They ran from Samson because they saw God's love and God's power through him. Now, what can we learn from this lesson? It was Samson's faith through God that he could defeat any army, and we must learn to obey God's command.